Here now with some final thoughts, Chris Dyerwell, our Fox News digital politics editor, and Howard Kurtz, host of Media Buzz on Fox News. Chris, your thoughts.
Man, I tell you what, that was a rip snorter. That was pretty good. You have Trump demonstrates that his voters are real, but they're not as real as the polling suggests. You have Ted Cruz delivers on his promise. He looks like a traditional Iowa winner, like we've seen, like Huckabee and Santorum, but he's got some steel in his belted radials, right? He's got more money, more organization, more national stuff, the chance to turn it into something else. But probably the single most important thing that happened, probably beyond anything else for the Republican Party, is they started to get their act together, right? They started to figure out that you can't have a Huckabee, a Santorum, and a Cruz. You can't have a Rubio and a Bush and a Kasich and a Christie. And I tell you what, no human being in history has spent more money to finish at 3% than Jeb Bush. Mm-hmm. And so now, as that part of the Republican Party, that sort of the traditional Republican Party, moves on, as that goes forward, Marco Rubio took a big step ahead. Now you've got a three-man race. Now you start to see the contours, and Donald Trump has to face a new reality where he's going to have to work harder for these votes, and he's going to face two tough other guys.
Howie?
Ted Cruz deserves credit not just for beating Donald Trump, but this is a guy who, when he got into the race, the Beltway establishment felt, well, he was a bomb thrower, he was an extremist, he was hated by the party establishment. They didn't see him as a top-tier guy, so he pulled something off here. Two caveats. One is, I do think he hurt himself a little bit with that 40-minute speech. I thought he'd just start reading from Green Eggs and Ham. It went on so long. Secondly, we always get swept up in the Iowa afterglow, and it is intense. But as you know, for the last six winners of the Iowa caucuses on the GOP side did not win the nomination. This was a tailor-made state for Ted Cruz. He had to win it. He did win it, but he's going to have a tougher time in places like New Hampshire, for example.
Mm-hmm. Well, speak about the endorsements. Glenn Beck came in for Cruz at the last minute, really said he's a constitutional conservative. He loves America. He loves the Constitution. That's the way he's going to govern.
Right.
Sarah Palin made a big splash coming out for Donald Trump and lending her Tea Party bona fides to him. In the end, it didn't make the difference.
Well, it didn't make the difference. Donald Trump failed to participate in Iowa's only presidential Republican debate. That was a terrible decision. It was spun by his many, many admirers in the press as a genius play. Iowans wanted to hear what he had to say in that presidential debate. He snubbed them. That was foolish, and the result reveals it. You have to play by some of the rules. Everybody likes the fact that Donald Trump doesn't play by the rules. But in this case, you got to play by some of them, and one of them is you got to do the debate. Now, we'll see if he'll become a more disciplined campaigner. We'll see if he can keep himself in check. He, again, 25% of the vote in Iowa for a guy most famous for hosting The Apprentice is pretty daggone good. Mm-hmm. And he should be proud of what he's got, and his voters should be proud of what they did. But if he can't figure out a way to run like a regular candidate a little more and do what he has to do, not going to be good.
This clearly dents Trump's armor of invincibility, which he had going for him. And I agree about the debate, and I also think Ted Cruz had a much better ground game, a very traditional thing to do in the Iowa caucuses. But, maybe it's not such a bad thing for Donald Trump to get a little dose of humility. A lot of people think he's too braggadocious and so forth. He had to be a little humble coming out here today.
He was a gentleman tonight.
He was.
People, yeah. He's going to melt down. No, he's not going to do that. And he's still got a lot of enthusiastic support. New Hampshire is a much better state for him. And he doesn't need money. He used his own money. But I also think a boost for Marco Rubio because he played the expectations game right, and therefore he's seen as getting a boost in third
place. And his speech was quite something to listen to. All about America. This is not my story. This is our story. This is America's story. How about that?